I'm with Dr. Alan Manning, who knows more about insurance than just about anybody I know. Alan, we've seen earthquakes in Nepal, we've seen floods in Australia, we've seen storms and quite a lot of storm damage. What do you think that will do to insurance prices?
Surprisingly, I don't think it'll do that much at all. Australia, we've had six events in the last 6 months, starting with some hailstorms in Brisbane. We've had storms in Sydney and Newcastle, Brisbane. We had some bushfires in South Australia. Altogether, that's probably going to be about $2.5 billion. That's not a record. In 2011, we had 8 disasters at nearly $5 billion. That pushed the price up. But at the moment, the insurance industry believes it can cope. The reinsurance programs that are in place are going to be adequate, and we shouldn't see any major changes.
$2.5 billion sounds a lot, but I guess in a world market, that's not too bad.
No, look, the Australian insurance premium income is about $35 billion. So, yes, it's going to hurt the bottom line of some insurers, but they're all very strong insurers with good reinsurance programs. What I think we need at the moment is for prices to increase, if that's what you want. I know most consumers would like to see it at these low levels, but I just don't think it's sustainable. I think the price has to go up, but it's going to take two really big catastrophes somewhere in the world, or two or more catastrophes, really big ones, to really shape all this new capital that's coming in. At the moment, it seemed to be a profitable industry and people are coming in. But as we know in this industry, the catastrophes could hit you anywhere and are certainly getting larger.
How much of a rise do you think we should see in the industry?
Oh, that's a good place. Look, I'm a claims person, not an underwriter. But I would have thought that we certainly don't want to see it going down any further. It just puts too much pressure on costs and then people don't start paying claims as quick as they should. We want it to be sustainable for our economy, for the insurers that are out there and for our customers. I'd like to see at least 10, maybe 20%, but that's just personal view, not necessarily the industry view.
Alan, thank you very much. We've learned a little bit more about insurance today.